Okay. In the last video lecture, I have solved problem on single phase AC distributor. In this video lecture, we shall solve a three phase AC distributor. Okay. I will just read out the problem statement. A three phase 400 volt distributor AB is loaded as shown in the figure. It is given. The three phase load at point C takes 5 amps per phase at a power factor of 0.8 lagging. At point B, a three phase 400 volt induction motor is connected which has an output of 10 HP with an efficiency of 90% and power factor of 0.85 lagging. If voltage at point B is to be maintained at 400 volts, what should be the voltage at point A? The resistance and reactance of the line are 1 ohm and 0.5 ohm per phase per kilometer respectively. Okay. Okay. So let us analyze this problem. Okay. He has given this distributor AB. It's given, okay, distributor AB is given, and there are two loads, one is at point C, another one is point B. C is 600 meter from point A and B is 400 meter from point C. So total B is 1 kilometer away from point A. Okay, the load that is connected at point C is 5 amps per phase and it is lagging by a power factor of 0.8. So for a convenient we shall consider this three phase distributor for as a single phase distributor, then we will calculate the single phase voltage at the sending end, and then we calculate what is the three phase voltage of this. Okay, so for convenience, we will consider single phase only. Even though it is a three phase, we will consider it as a single phase. We calculate, we apply all the procedure to calculate what is sending end voltage of a single phase. Then, after calculating a single phase voltage, then we will convert it into three phase. Okay, so a distributor is AB and it is loaded, okay, at point C it is loaded, the load current is 5 amps and power factor is 0.8 lagging. At point B, what is point B? It's a receiving end voltage. At point B, an induction motor, 400 volt induction motor is connected, okay. The output of this induction motor is 10 HP, okay, and it has an efficiency of 90%. Fine, and it is lagging at a power factor of 0.85, and the distributor resistance and reactance are given here, 1 ohm and 0.5 ohm per phase per kilometer. Okay, so it is convenient to consider one phase only. Okay. Even though it is a three phase, we will consider only one phase and then we will convert that into three phase later on. Impedance of the distributor per phase per kilometer is given, 1 plus j of 0.5 ohm. Okay. Next, let us see. Impedance of section. What has been asked, if the voltage at point B is to be maintained at 400 volt, what should be the voltage at point A? You need to calculate what is the voltage at point A, that is a sending end voltage. If you want to calculate the voltage at point A, then you must you should know what is the voltage at point C. So add what voltage at point B to voltage at point C, and then what is the voltage drop in this section, okay, then you will get what is the voltage at point A. Understood this? Okay. If you add the drop, voltage drop in section CB to VB, what you will get is VC. If you add voltage drop in section AC to VC, you will get VA. Or else the other way, you know what is VB, he has given 400 volts. Okay, 400 volts is at point B. Then to this 400 volts, you have to add voltage drop in section CB plus voltage drop in section AC. So you will get VA. Okay, so how do you get voltage drop in section CB? You have to multiply the current in section CB with impedance of section CB. ZCB multiplied with ICB. What is ICB? I2. What is I2? I have written here 14.08. How did you get this 14.08? I will show you that. How did you get? See here. Efficiency is given. Efficiency is output power by input power multiplied by 100. Okay, efficiency is given 0.9, and the output power here is given in terms of HP. You convert this into watts. So how do you convert HP multiplied by 746? You will get it in watts divided by input power P. Let us take this P as the input power. So P is equal to root 3 because it's 3 phase, right? So P is equal to root 3 VI cos phi. Now calculate what is I. Okay, I is nothing but load I2. Current. Okay, I2 is equal to HP into 746 divided by root 3. What is VA? He has given 400 volts. What is power factor? 0.85 and 0.9. This, which I have got 14.08 amps, which I have shown here 14.08. Okay, so this is your I2 load current. So if you multiply this I2, has to be this is a magnitude, okay, but it has to be converted into vector. How do you convert? I2 vector is equal to I2 into cos phi 2 minus j of sin phi 2. Okay, you know this. So that I have solved this. Now impedance of section AC, ZAC is equal to 1 plus j 0.5 ohm, but it is per phase per kilometer. Okay, so it is per kilometer, but we have to convert this into 600 meters. But why 600 meter? Because I have to calculate what is the impedance of section AC and what is the length of section AC, 600 meter. Okay, therefore, what I have done here, 1 plus J 0.5, which is for 1 kilometer, it has to be converted into 600 meter. So when we convert it, what I have got is 0.6 plus J of 0.3 ohm. Okay, similarly, you can calculate what is the impedance of section CB. What is the impedance of section CB? ZCB is equal to 1 plus J of 0.5 multiplied by what is the length of section CB? 400 meters. So 400 divided by 1000, which is equal to 0.4 plus J of 0.2 ohms. Okay, now phase voltage at point B, VB, is equal to phase voltage, you have to calculate at point B, that is 400 by 400 volts divided by root 3. Okay, he has given the voltage point B is 3 phase voltage, that is 400, but I have to convert it into per phase value. Okay, what is the phase voltage at point B? Is VB, which is equal to 400 divided by root 3, which is equal to 231 volts. Okay, now I have calculated what is the load current at point B, just now I explained to you. Okay, now next. Now the load current at point B, which is a vector I2, vector is equal to I2 cos phi 2 minus j of sin phi 2. Okay, which is equal to 14.08 into bracket 0.85 cos phi 2 minus j of sin phi 2. This you will get, if you convert this into sin phi 2, you will get 0.527. How do you convert? First calculate phi 2. What is phi 2? Cos phi 2 is 0.85. So you calculate phi 2 is equal to cos inverse of 0.85, you get some phi 2. So you calculate sin phi 2. So you will get 0.527. So when you multiply, when you multiply this, what you will get is 12 minus J of 7.4 amps. This is the vector current I2 at point B. Similarly, you can calculate what is the current in section CB. Current in section CB, ICB is nothing but I2 only. So that is 12 minus J 7.4. See, current in section ICB. ICB same as I2. Okay? Okay. So we have calculated what is the current in section CB. That is ICB is 12 minus J of 7.4 amps. Now, what is the current at point C? Current at point C, see here. Current at point C is I1, magnitude of the current, that is 5 amps. Now, vector of I1 is equal to I1 cos phi 1 minus J of sin phi 1. Right? I1 is equal to, vector I1 is equal to I1 cos phi 1 minus J of sin phi 1, which I have got 4 minus J3 amps. So, now calculate what is the current in section AC. Current in section AC is vector sum of I1 plus vector sum of I1 plus I2. So, vector sum of I1 plus I2, which is 16 minus J of 10.4. Voltage drop in section CB, which is equal to VCB, is equal to ICB multiplied by ZCB, which is 6.28 minus J of 0.56. Okay. Similarly, what is the voltage drop in section AC? VAC is equal to IAC, current in that section, multiplied by the impedance of section AC. So, what you will get is 12.72 minus J of 1.44 volts. Okay. This you can write it. It's volts. Volts. And what is this? Amps. Okay. Now, similarly, voltage at point A per phase. All these are per phase values only. Okay. Voltage at point A per phase is, as I told you, VA is equal to VB plus VCB plus VAC. Correct? Voltage at point A per phase is equal to VB plus VCB plus VAC. So, if you add all those things, finally what you will get is 250 minus J2. Okay, this is the voltage at point A, sending end voltage per phase. So, when you convert into magnitude, what you will get is 250 at an angle of minus 0.45 degree. So, what is the line voltage now? It is a per phase. Right? 250 volts is per phase value. Now you have to convert this into line voltage. So line voltage at point A is root 3 times of 250, which is equal to 433 volts. This is the line voltage at point A. What is the line, what is the voltage at point A? Which is nothing but sending end voltage. So what is the sending end voltage? 433 volts. Okay?